The world's largest retailer is limiting the amount of ammunition shoppers across the country can buy. Walmart set a maximum of 3 boxes a customer a day. A spokeswoman tells CNN, "We're trying to serve as many customers as possible. We're in contact with our suppliers, and we'll look at our purchase limits once the suppliers are in a better place." And Walmart isn't the only one. A Cabela's store in Pennsylvania told us they're setting a limit of 10 boxes a day for certain rounds, mainly semi-automatic weapons. There are reports of increased demand and ammunition shortages at retail stores nationwide. Firearms dealers and the NRA have a few hunches why. Increased gun sales since Sandy Hook. FBI background checks, the most dependable indicator for firearm sales, have reached record highs. More guns means more ammo. Higher traffic at gun ranges. The Blue Ridge Arsenal in Virginia said they have increased activity and shooters are buying more rounds.
Ammo that we sell, we're averaging about 80 rounds per customer. It's probably increased a little bit more recently.
And the threat of increased taxes could be a factor, too. In Connecticut, the state where the Sandy Hook shooting occurred, there is a proposal to have a 50% tax on ammo. Whatever the cause, Walmart's decision to set limits on ammunition is what Democratic Connecticut Senator Richard Blumenthal would like to see happen on a broader scale. He's proposed legislation that would limit ammunition sales for individuals and require background checks for ammo as well.
Right now, a fugitive, a felon, a drug addict, a domestic abuser can walk into a store, buy a shopping cart full of ammunition.
What's not entirely clear is how Walmart will enforce this limit. It doesn't appear that there's anything in place to stop customers from making multiple trips to the same store in a day or going to different stores. We've reached out to Walmart on that, but didn't get an answer.
We know what kind of ammunition is being sold in these big numbers.
Well, interestingly, we talked to a few different folks in the field, and a lot of them said 223 rounds. These are the rounds that would go into, say, an AR-15, which is the very popular weapon that people all over the country are buying and is also the source of controversy here on Capitol Hill when we talk about semi-automatic weapons.
Joe Johns reporting for us. Thank you.